At the start of May, I began development of a new game called Sidestep Legends, a MOBA-inspired roguelite about dodging spells, a mix between League of Legends and Vampire Survivors, with a focus on dodging skill shots. Since this game is relying on the Vampire Survivors hype, it had to be made quickly, before the hype potentially dies out, or the market gets too crowded with this type of games. But making a game quickly is important. It would make sense to use a game engine to get going fast. Especially Unity would fit well in this scenario and for this type of game. However, I ended up not using an engine at all, but instead a library called Raylib. Why did I do that? And looking back now, 5 months later, was it a good choice or maybe a mistake? So why should you listen to me at all? I quickly go through my background, so you can decide if you think what I'm talking about will be relevant to you. I have been working professionally with game development the last 6 years. For the first 4.5 years, I worked as an engine developer for a 2D game engine for casino games. That engine was written in C# and used DirectX for rendering. The last 1.5 years I spent developing a 3D football game for virtual sports betting using Unity. So while my professional experience had mostly been with C#, none of my side projects have been. During this time in my free time, I made a mobile game with Java and libgdx called Touch a Turn. I later did a redesign of it and released it on Steam as Dextrum. In between, I have also been working on a traffic simulation game in assembly that you might have seen if you're a regular of the channel. So I have been trying out some different technologies and programming languages over the years. Back to May this year, when I decided to put the traffic simulation game to the side for a while to quickly make and release Sidestep Legends. I have always enjoyed building things on my own, and using full game engines has never been appealing to me. I had especially been enjoying working in assembly and DirectX in my traffic simulation game. My first choice would have been to continue with assembly and DirectX for this game, but since the game had to be made quite quickly, I had to compromise a little bit at least, and then Raylib looked like a good choice to get things going. I had recently tried out Raylib in a Ludendare game jam and confirmed I can get things up and running quickly with it. It is always good to look back at decisions you have made and reflect if you made the right one in order to make better decisions in the future. So looking back at these 5 months, should I have gone the whole way and used a full engine like Unity, or was going with Raylib the right choice? But first, a word from the sponsor of this video, me. I recently went full time working on my own as a game developer, so please buy my game Dextrum and wishlist Sidestep Legends on Steam so I can eat. Links are in the description. Thanks, let's get back to the video. Let's start with good things about Unity, things that could have been useful for this game. The first big thing is of course the editor. While I mostly like working straight with code, there is no denying in some tasks an editor will be superior. I got around this issue quite well by using Blender as my level editor for the game. In there, I could build the whole level by just placing the models where I wanted them. I also placed out some cubes to represent colliders to avoid having to check collisions against the full complex meshes. One part of the editor that would have been really useful is the particle system. That and just having the editor in general for making spell effects would have been quite useful. Doing the effects all by code is not as fast as dragging sliders in an editor. This can be solved, however, by me making a simple editor for spell effects. But of course, that is time that could have been spent making content for the game. I still don't mind making the spell effects through code, though. The only time I really missed having an editor a lot was when making the skill tree for the game. All in all, it did not take that much time. I had it made over 3 evenings, but it was really not enjoyable. With an editor, I would probably have had it done in at most a third of the time, but more importantly, the frustration level would have been much lower. Lastly, one point where Unity has an advantage is the render engine, especially the lighting. Raylib does not come with any out-of-the-box lighting system, so I had to implement those parts myself. The largest part of it was probably the shadows, which is not that big of a deal to implement yourself. A simple shadow map solution works well for my type of game, but that was time that could have been spent adding more content to the game. The lighting part has also taken some time to make look decent enough, while in Unity it would have been much quicker. So with all these points towards Unity, have there been any good points about Raylib that would make it worth missing out on the Unity goodies? The main point for me has been enjoyment. First of all, programming language. After over 6 years of using C# professionally, I have come to really dislike the language. I am aware that this is likely to be a controversial opinion, but I really think C# is not well suited to make games, or even production code in general. But that is another discussion that could be a whole video on its own. I find C much more enjoyable to program in. You have much better control over things when you have proper pointers, and memory management is so much more pleasant and easier to make performant when there is no garbage collector. But maybe the largest benefit of Raylib compared to Unity is that it's open source and free. Let's start with the free part. So far, the games I have released have been made using a free open source Java library called libgdx. Side note, libgdx is a great library, but I don't recommend using Java for game development. Don't do it. This means updating and maintaining them does not require me to pay for a license. If I was to use Unity for this game, this would be the first one where I would end up needing to pay for a license for as long as I want or need to make updates to the game. Sure, there is a free version of Unity if you don't make over a certain amount of money, but with the reputation Unity has among gamers, I think developers that are not paying to get rid of the Unity splash screen are doing themselves a disservice. So any technology that requires me to continuously pay money as long as I want to update my game will have to provide a lot of value not found in any free alternatives to make up for it. Secondly, the open source part. Raylib being open source is a huge benefit. While working with Unity at my last job, we ran into several bugs in Unity's systems that would probably have been very easy to solve if we would have had access to the source code of the engine. Instead, of course, after reporting the bugs to the Unity team, we had to make various workarounds to fix them. Unity also had much more bugs and badly working features than what I would expect from one of the market leader game engines. While I have run into some bugs in Raylib as well, with it being open source, and at the same time its code being very straightforward and easy to understand, I could easily fix it myself, and most often the bug was already fixed in a later version of the framework. It also helps whenever I see a part of the library that almost does what I needed to do, but not quite. Then I can either edit the library code directly, or simply copy the parts from it I need to alter and have my own version of it in my code, which I have done several times in this project already. With Unity in the same situation, you just have to accept that their stuff works as it does, and either change your game design, find a way to work around it, or just write your own version of the functionality from scratch. Another benefit of Raylib is that it's just very pleasant to work with. Everything is simple, and there's just no bullshit. You want to draw some text on the screen to debug something? Just call the draw text function and enter your text. No need to create a game object with a text component and hook it up to a script to write things in it. Want to play sound from code? Just call the play sound function and send in the sound object you want to play. So now some of you might be thinking, I'm wondering if he has heard about Godot. I have, and it does look like almost all of the good points about Raylib would also fit into Godot. Then why not get the best of both worlds? Free and open source, simple to understand, and a full engine with an editor. Godot could have been a good choice for this game. It is also easy and fast to build the engine yourself and work with it more as if it was a library that happens to have an editor rather than a full engine, so it might fit me quite well. Still, even if it's not as complex as Unity, it's more complex than I currently need for Sidestep Legends, so no point in introducing more complexity than necessary. And the most interesting part of Godot would be the new renderer in Godot 4, which at the time I started with Sidestep Legends was only in alpha, and still now is only in beta. And that is just some unneeded uncertainty for me right now. I could see myself porting the game to Godot if I end up deciding I want or need a more sophisticated renderer. That is another good thing with Raylib. The API is very well made, and the way I have structured my game, it would be quite painless to port my game to another library, or in this case Godot, as long as C is supported. Which technically Godot supports, since it's written in C++, which is just a superset of C. So, to answer the original question at the start of the video, was it a mistake to use Raylib instead of Unity? For me, I would say it was not. There were some things that took a bit longer than it would have with Unity, but in the end, I think it still went faster with Raylib. Just for the simple reason that I have really enjoyed my time working with Raylib and writing in C. I know working with Unity and C# would not have been as enjoyable for me. And up until a couple of weeks ago, I was doing all the work on the game during my free time, and most of it during my summer vacation. So being motivated and having fun while working on it has been a major factor in getting things done. Does that mean that everyone should stop using Unity and use Raylib instead? Of course not. If you like using Unity, that is probably a good fit for you. It is a good engine and a lot of good games have been made with it. But don't underestimate how important it is to enjoy working with the tools that you are working with. If you find yourself feeling unmotivated or thinking game engines seem a bit too complicated for what you want to do, using a simple library might actually be a good idea. Raylib especially is something I would recommend to anyone who wants to start with game dev and have an interest in programming, since it's so beginner friendly. And if C is not the programming language for you, there are bindings for a lot of different programming languages. Even C#, though why anyone would want to use it over C is beyond my understanding. Thank you for watching, and don't forget that C# is a script language.